Even if it's just 15 months, I'm not bad.
Mow.
Not bad, eh?
Not bad, no.
Do it again. This is what we call real talent. Nailed it. Fucking 10 out of 10.
There's another one here.
Come on, boys,
big show.
It's from boys.
It's from.
Here we go. You've got to handle the Wilmot.
Yeah.
Still a shit house.
Pressure! Nowhere!
Yes, baby!
Here we go, baby!
Oh, you're
that is your
That's my question.
Ball nine.
Harvey, kill someone.
Hello, welcome to Roses 2023. We're joined on a Sunday day, and it's University of York Men's Ones versus Lancaster Men's Ones. I'm joined here with Joe.
Hello, hello, Alexis. How are you?
I'm not bad. How are you?
Yeah, I'm not too bad. It's been a lovely weekend, I must say. I thought it'd be a bit rainier, but the weather has held out for us.
And, we've currently watched the first 10 minutes. I'm sorry the stream has been a bit late, but we're watching the first 10 minutes. It's a Lancaster injury in Lancaster's half at the moment. It's been all Lancaster, really, this half.
But we've had some really strong play here, some really strong tackles from York, and a really, really surprising scrum from Lancaster, where they managed to completely destroy the York forwards.
Yeah, but it's looking like it's going to be a really good contest today. Lancaster's scrum half just shanked the kick out into the left wing. York's left wing, Lancaster's right wing. It's now a line-out to York. We'll see. This will be the first line-out of the game. Hopefully, both teams can set some good set pieces here, and we'll see how the lineup goes.
Absolutely. We've been watching them practicing their set pieces so far, and they were looking good.
Apologies, it's Lancaster's lineup.
Yeah.
And Lancaster has
really,
one line-out.
Really strong line-out there.
Lancaster now play out the backs.
Some really good ball movement there.
Oh, that's a good strong handoff there from Lancaster. The York have challenged. Oh. Okay, looks like there was an interference. Oh, offside. That was called offside.
Yeah.
York have now been marched back 10 metres. Lancaster now have an opportunity to take advantage of this. I think they'll kick it to the sideline.
100%. It's looking a lot like it.
And they'll take the line out if it does go out.
Yeah. Though, you were correct.
Yep.
Lancaster have shanked out to their right-hand sideline.
It's going to be line out to Lancaster. So, Joe, what were you thinking about the tackles made earlier?
They were aggressive tackles. Really, really aggressive tackles from York. Lancaster trying to drive through the defence, but not getting anywhere, giving up no ground whatsoever.
I mean, they are big lads. Again, they are physically a very strong team.
100%.
They are a division above York, so they have got that high calibre. But then, hopefully, York can show that being the underdogs here, size-wise, 100%. Doesn't mean anything.
And York have had a really good season so far. They've won their last four games. They started off a bit weak, but they've won their last four games. So I think the York men's first team are really going to try and put on a good performance here.
Yeah, definitely.
Obviously, if they win this match, it will be a whitewash for York in the rugby.
Yeah, I think it's going to be a big, big game today. The crowds have really come out today as well. We're seeing grandstands being erected as well. So there's a lot of crowds around. And I'm looking forward to seeing how they get into the game as well.
100%. So Lancaster just on their left-hand wing, trying to drive past. There's a bit of a maul going on, but the ball's been released. And Lancaster have been really strong on the ruck. York haven't been really challenging the rucks here.
I think it's probably due to the sizing. Also, again, if you keep players out, you have more of a defence at the line.
100%.
The line speed have been quite good. Though York have been unlucky to be offside, but that is just part of the game.
It happens.
Lancaster looking strong in their set pieces. Lancaster running up past the York halfway line. Looks like they're challenging in the York 22 now. The scrum half has decided to take it on his own.
Unsuccessfully?
Yeah, very unsuccessfully.
Yeah, I think Lancaster, especially when I was watching the men's seconds, had a bit of an issue with not putting out to the wings. They were trying to drive through and getting very little ground. And when they were moving it across the wings, they were moving it horizontally and not forward.
Yeah.
They weren't finding those gaps. But, you know, maybe they'll change up play today.
I'm sure the ones have a different game plan to the two.
Oh, 100%.
I'm intrigued to see how they adapt and sort of become pragmatic. Yeah. York win a penalty here. Lancaster did not release the ball.
No.
York have regained possession in a very important position of the field as well. The line...
York will really want to be materialising on this now.
Linesman's making sure that everyone's on side. Now I'm intrigued to see why the linesman is on the field rather than on the sideline. But
does he
know? Kick squatted down by Seaford there, and it's been kicked forward by Billy Charles.
There's a chase on to the try line. I think
Henry
it's going to go dead.
And it was made dead by the Lancaster defender. A good piece of play by York there.
Fantastic
Looking
bit of play.
Very promising from York, you know.
Materialising on the ball fell out of his hands. It could have been a knock-on, but he got his foot to it first, and there was a bit of a chase, but obviously the Lancastrians were victorious. So the score currently is 0-0.
And it's looking like it's going to be a
points
very
to anyone.
Good game, though.
100%.
It's been a very exciting first half. I think there might be a bit of wind, you know, affecting the kicks, because it's looking like the kicks aren't
there
going very
definitely
far.
Was yesterday. You could tell. Lancaster's conversion rate as well, really really poor conversions from Lancaster for the seconds anyway, so I think that might be due to the wind partially, and it seems to be the same today.
Looks
so
like York building up play now. They've taken a little box kick into the corner. Can York and York has scored an incredible try.
Fantastic.
In the right wing, nicely dotted over by Billy Charles and dotted into the corner by I believe Henry Miles. An incredible try from York. And
that was very.
Scoring.
I thought that had gone dead, to be honest. I thought that was in the dead zone, but no, he plopped it right in the bottom right corner of the field.
Again,
that was very impressive.
Something out of nothing there.
100%.
Incredible first try. That's 5-0 to York, and that starts off our scoring today. Joe, I've got to say, that was a very good try.
Really good. Really good set piece there.
Do you reckon it was out
there? I thought it might have been. When I was looking at it, I thought he hasn't kept that in, but when I saw the ball had just been basically just plopped down by Billy Charles there, and you know, that was a really, really, really good, it was probably partially luck where he's just managed to get there in time. However, it was a really good bit of play.
I don't know, it was I think it was all skill there really, but
all
again,
skill.
We don't have unfortunately we don't have any TMO, so we can't really go for any televised match officials, but
no.
That was a really good try and a great start to the scoring for York.
Who's taking the conversion here, Alexis?
It's Hex Campbell Long, the University of York Rugby Club president.
So he's taking it from the wing.
It's a harsh angle. I think he has just made a great kick there to make it
7-0.
It is 7-0 to the University of York. Again, Lancaster have been all over York, but York again making something out of nothing. It's been a good half of rugby.
But yeah, coming back to the halfway line.
Not looking too happy.
No, not at all.
And the game has restarted again. Looks like he shanked the kick straight out. I think the pressure's got to Lancaster now, you know. I think 100%. They need to sort of reset and come and get...
They started off really strong. They might have psyched themselves out.
Has picked up again. So.
Certainly has. If you look at the end flags, you'll be able to tell that the wind is picking up.
But that was an unfortunate shanked kick from Lancaster scrum half, and now it's a scrum to York.
The wind is blowing in York's favour as well. It's blowing towards their try line, the Lancastrian try line. But there's nothing you can do about that.
No, exactly. You just got to play with the weather. This is going to be a big scrum on the halfway line. Just a reminder, it's 7-0 to York. So this is really Lancaster's imperative to win the scrum and gain possession again. So that's a strong scrum.
Just a fun fact while this scrum's happening. Oh, the scrum's gone up a little bit.
Billy Charles has cleared the lines straight into Lancastrian 22. Oh, the Lancaster fullback had a bit of mare there, but he's regathered the ball nicely. He's going to clear his lines. Oh, he's tackled there. Looks like York have an opportunity to score here. If York can win this breakdown, they have a great opportunity to score. The left wing is
York's really trying to push through just yards away from the try line
here. Lancaster have won that breakdown. No, I'm wrong. Lancaster did not roll away, so it's a York penalty. York an incredible scoring opportunity here. It is
very close. Again, and that was because of the Lancaster number 15 just not getting to the ball in time.
Yeah, didn't gather it very well.
Just butter fingers, slipped out of his hands.
An unfortunate bounce to the ground as well. Again, 22 acres is not the fastest of surfaces.
No.
So the rugby ball will bounce in unfortunate angles and ways.
These aren't lab conditions, you know. It's
not quite Twickenham, but it's our Twickenham, as they say.
Certainly is.
It looks like Lancaster, York have opted to go for the posts to take the 3 points. It's a safe opportunity, I think. Go for the free, just get points on the board and play it safe, you know.
Definitely. Just a fun little fact while we're waiting for this conversion. I found it earlier. Matthew Precious has climbed Kilimanjaro, which is, to be honest, I think playing against some of these players might remind him of that because they are mountains.
Okay, thank you for that, Jay.
You're very welcome.
We'll see if Hector can convert this. Yeah, that's 3 points on the board. So it's now 10-0 to the University of York.
Glided right through the pass.
A way to go to get up on the board. Again, very early in the second and first half here, though. So Lancaster still do have a lot of opportunities to score. What do you think Lancaster needs to change up here, though, Jay?
You see, both of those, that first try was the result of a really good bit of play from York, but that second one was simply just not getting to the ball in time. It slipped out of his hands. It was an unfortunate angle of the ball anyway, the angle of the bounce. And again, it's just they've managed to catch it again, but it was just a sloppy bit of play. But that was some really good driving there. Just slipped through York.
Lancaster seem to be targeting the left wing quite a lot.
They definitely are.
Oh, Matt Preston has stripped the ball there. And there's a big tackle by Henry Miles. And York has won the ball again. York are all over Lancaster at the moment. It's looking like it's going to be a very good game here, rugby.
100%. So just to catch up there, the ball was ripped out of the hands by, who was it?
Matt Precious. Lancastrian players.
But the Lancastrian player managed to get it back in his hands, but the ref still called the scrum with York putting it.
Again, it's the next opportunity for Lancaster to assert dominance again. It is York scrum, so if Lancaster can win it here, they can keep possession in York's half and could go and potentially make some good use of it.
And Lancaster have been really aggressive with their scrum, and you can see it there.
God, that is a
really aggressive bit of scrumming there.
Okay, University of York are running driving their right wing now. Some big tackles in centre field.
York have really been targeting that right wing today.
Yeah, again, they've got some dynamic players on that wing and they're really trying to make use of them. Some big tackles today, though. They're going to feel it in the half. Looks like Hector's now playing out. They're doing a little set piece here. Harry Clamp has kicked
bit of a chase going, but Lancaster easily get it.
Cleared their centre lines. Not very well, though, into the midfield. Looks like Hector's picked up. Passed it to Harry Clamp. Harry Clamp has now taken it downfield.
Some really good run there.
He's very good run. He's taken some hits there as well. York have
a really good ruck there from York to say that they were weaker in the rucks at the start of the match.
Yep. Oh, Purvis has cleared. Oh, a late tackle there. Again, the fullback is struggling with these balls that are coming downfield. I think York are really trying to take advantage of that.
100%.
He's gathered it nicely though, and it looks like Lancaster have got possession of the ball now.
York's really chasing when that fullback drops it, which he's done a couple of times now.
Again, nerves, you know. Also,
there's a lot of pressure on this game. A lot of pressure.
Huge crowd as well. Hundreds of people here.
And when York are driving that right wing there next to their own supporters as well, so clearly not as easy for the Lancaster players.
Kick. Looks like York can gather this nicely if they can. A bit of a collision there for York players, but it's taken well by York.
Safe hands at number 11 there. Really strong catch there.
Lancaster really challenging his breakdowns, trying to get the ball back. York are running
driving off there, but driven back by Lancaster.
They're playing it down the right wing again, repeatedly. And they've kicked it back. Taken nicely by Lancaster, they've got possession well. Chased down by York very quickly. And it's a penalty to Lancaster. Looks like not rolling away and not releasing. Unfortunately, couldn't really tell from this angle. Again, the sun is in my eyes.
And they are on the other side of the pitch.
Yeah, exactly. But a good bit of rugby so far. I'm enjoying it.
Fantastic. I'm having a great time. I'm having a fantastic time. It's really intense and you can really tell that this is the last match
like
of rugby.
Lancaster have kicked it into the irrigation ditch. Hopefully the ball will be gathered nicely. So what do you think Lancaster needs to do differently? Or is a quick substitution happening?
Yeah.
Looks like Matt Precious is going off for Seth. I wonder if... I think I've got the wrong person there. Again, can't really see from this distance. But someone has gone off and Seth has come on and Max Buckingham has come on for the University of York.
So I think after pondering on your question, I think Lancaster really need to work their wings more.
Okay.
I think that's the issue.
They need to keep the ball downfield as well?
Definitely. They haven't been chasing the ball as much as York have, and their tackles haven't been as clean either.
Okay.
But their driving has been really good, and their rucking has been really
strong,
good so far.
Strong players as well.
And of course, their scrums are really good, but they haven't managed to win any of York's scrums so far. So it's going to be a line out with... is that Lancaster putting in?
Yeah,
I can't see.
It is Lancaster.
Fantastic.
Throwing it in. Looks like there's some issues at the moment. Oh, it's scavenging the ball. Essentially, the ball has gone out of play and they've had to get a new ball. Okay, the ball's now in play. Looks like Lancaster are going to throw it into the lineup. Lancaster have won the lineup there. Oh, but it was not thrown straight, so York have got possession again. Lancaster having some repeated mistakes. I wonder
really, really poor.
Again,
sloppy.
It is sloppy, but it's just part of the game, unfortunately. And we have to credit them. They are student athletes, after all. They're not professionals.
Nope.
They are playing in probably one of the largest crowds I've ever played in as well.
100%.
And again, it's some good rugby. I'm really enjoying how this game's going. Again, hopefully Lancaster can sort of pick up on their mistakes and sort of build up play, you know, and sort of form a better standard. Again,
York set pieces, very well. Yeah, their set pieces have just been hitting different.
Hitting different.
That's a technical term.
Very technical term. York have now got the ball, dishing out into the centres. Another set of play here. Looks like they've got spaces on the wing. The left
really
wing
good
is
bit
exposed.
Of space there.
He broke the tackle and the line out.
Kept it in play there. Did he keep it in play? No, he just put out of play.
Grazed the left wing. The line out to Lancaster as York had possession there.
Really good tackle there from Lancaster.
Really try and save the tackle potentially.
Yeah. Because it was a dangerous position there. So
a bit of a clutch tackle. Again, this is the highlight of the season for many of these players, and it's a really big game for these guys. The lineout is being thrown in by Lancaster. Oh, it was challenged by York, but Lancaster have won it successfully. Lancaster have engaged in the maul here.
Number six needs to be careful, I think, with
and Lancaster have regained possession.
So I count five Lancaster players, which is this is their Roses debut. So. A lot of pressure on them, I think.
Yeah,
obviously, it will be the biggest crowd they've played in front of.
In a while, I believe. Though some of these guys have played the NatWest Cup finals and stuff like that. So there's a good calibre of rugby here.
Fantastic. Fantastic bit of rugby.
He's gathered the ball nicely. So York have got possession here in the midfield. Strong tackle by Lancaster. Taking him down. Henry Miles is making metres there. University of York have got possession. They've kicked it downfield again. Challenging the Lancaster winger and fullback. He's taking a nice bounce there. Lancaster fullback has taken the mark. Oh. So, looks like it's
high tackle?
Back for a high tackle, yeah.
Yeah.
it looks like Lancaster fans are having a nice sing song, and it's good to see that though. I'm really happy to see the sort of crowds here, particularly with COVID and how growth is protected.
Definitely.
It's good to see such a good away crowd attendance here.
The away crowd really has been very active these past 2 days.
It's a nice kick from York there. A really quite advantageous lineup position. We will see if York can take advantage of this. I'm predicting they'll probably look to do a maul and drive it into the corner post again. We'll see what happens though.
Let's see if you're right.
York are looking strong though. After a rough start in the beginning.
Definitely.
The
game, with that collapsed scrum.
And the knock on early on as well.
Yeah, definitely. Because they were completely driven out of play there.
Lancaster look like they've been exploited a bit by the York players. But
really good line out there from Scrum. From York.
Nice line out.
Lancaster's
got a run here. They've kicked downfield. Can Lancaster gather on this? The ball has stayed in play somehow. It's been gathered nicely by Charlie Mayhew. He's dished it out to Chris Totti.
Bit of a low pass
running
there.
He's broken a tackle there. He's broken enough. Oh, big hit there.
Really strong tackle from Lancaster.
York have gained possession again in the midfield. Max Buckingham was looking to dish it out into the centre field there. Oh, an unfortunate knock on there by Henry Miles.
But Henry Miles managed to kick it before it's knocked on.
The ref has brought it back.
Referee again, said no.
I'm sure Henry Miles, he knocked it on, but he came foot as well. So
I wasn't sure. I wasn't sure if that was a knock on there, because he did meet it with his foot, but clearly the ref says it's a knock on. It's a knock on.
Yeah, and it's going to be a Lancaster scrum. Again, apologies for any language you might hear. Again, this is live. And
nothing we can do about that, unfortunately. So it's going to be a Lancaster scrum here. God.
Looks like there's another substitution for University of York, I think. It's a roll on roll off subs, so everyone gets a game time. And it's really good to see, you know, everyone gets a rosy experience.
100%. Because it's something that you don't do very often, especially in front of this many people.
So Matthew Longness has come on for University of York. Okay, so the scrum is getting ready now. The scrum half's having a chat with the referee. It's going to be a big scrum for Lancaster.
Okay. Referee not happy with that scrum.
Looks like there was an early engagement. But yeah, it's looking like Lancaster are going to pick up a scrum here. Lancaster really needs to win this.
100%.
If you're Lancaster, the sort of centre field, you've got both options on the left. It looks like they're building up on the left wing with players. So I'm presuming they're going to take it on the left. We'll see what happens. It's a big scrum from both teams. Lancaster have won this, but it's looking like it's been collapsed a little bit. Looks like an early out of engagement, so Lancaster have got an advantage here. Lancaster's number 8 has taken it, but he's gone straight into the scrum. An unfortunate
really,
position there.
Really, really, really poor choice of run there.
Lancaster still have ball though. Oh, an unfortunate ball there. I think he must have just tripped on the 22 acres field.
He's either tripped on the 22 acres field or he's tripped on the man behind him. So I did see they were
big
quite close.
There. Right in front of us now, so we've got a great view of this.
Yeah. And I think you will probably be able to hear that collision there. The big thump. Number 22 just trying to drive through. Ball presented
to York. Looks like engaging from the side. So it's penalty to York. So it's been a really good game of rugby so far. It looks like Billy Charles is going to kick it to the corner. And the Lancaster fans are giving it large to York.
Really strong kick there.
Oh, he's
Lancaster keeping it
somehow.
A bit of a risk there because it could have been a knock-on, but
this guy is
really fantastic run. Fantastic run from number 15. Straight down.
York have regained possession. Looks like someone's in a lot of pain there. We can hear some screams.
There's a bit of rough and tumble going on.
Looks like a really unfortunate knee injury. Hopefully he's okay. That sounded really bad though.
Yeah, it certainly did. Yeah. But that was some aggressive play there from both teams.
I'm not looking at this horrible injury to see in here. During this injury break, it's going to be a good time for both teams to sort of gather up again and reset.
100%. That was a really good run from Lancaster though. Just brought down that number 15 there.
25 minutes of game has been played so far from one referee.
So, yeah.
Been a really, big game today. I've been enjoying this quite a lot.
A really, really exciting run there and a really promising one, but really solid tackle from York. Really direct, and it went from 100 to 0 really quick.
Yeah.
He was full pace and then on the ground. So a really strong tackle from York there and a really decisive one as well.
Yeah. So it looks like it was an unfortunate injury there, basically. He looks fine, though. He's on his feet again, which is really good to see.
Fantastic.
Essentially, his leg was just caught in the tackle. The breakdown happened, and he just got dragged along in it. He looks fine now. He's up on his feet, which is really good to see. This is an excellent opportunity, though, for Yunus if you want to talk about what we're going to do and change up. 15 minutes left of this half. You expect Lancaster to really bring it to York now.
Really, really drive York back, because York have been the attacking force, I think.
Yeah, very aggressive there this half, and some really strong clear outs in the breakdown. And really saying to Lancaster are a bigger team, but York, despite being small sides, have really shown it to Lancaster.
Definitely.
They are looking strong.
So I think Lancaster, if they try and find more opportunities like that where they can find gaps between the York defence, I think they might be able to get some points on the board.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. It looks like York are covering up now, and it should be a scrum. He's back on his feet. He's been clapped by his teammates.
That's really fantastic to see.
The time is back on now with 15 minutes remaining. What's the score, Patrick?
The score is 10-0. 10-0.
He just took over. So that's a try and to a conversion. And a drop. So there's still opportunities for Lancaster to come back here.
100%. So it is Lancaster putting into this scrum.
Yeah.
Let's see what this scrum's like. Scrum's binding.
And it's a big scrum here. The scrum is being wheeled by Lancaster. Lancaster have won it. Yep, it's the wheeling of the scrum here.
Really fantastic scrum there.
Lancaster have won it. They've taken the ball
broken.
Oh,
that was a high tackle.
Contact there to the face by. Oh, nice and swatted down. Yeah, it looks like a high tackle there.
Yeah. So just caught his face with his fist, which sounds a lot like a punch when you say it like that. But it definitely looked unintentional from where we stood.
I don't think there's any harm. But it looks like Lancaster have got a penalty. They have an excellent opportunity here to kick it down the field.
100%.
It looks like they have got an advantage position. Unfortunately, the Lancaster fans have sort of blocked my view of where they can kick it, though, so we'll see what happens. Looks like someone's gone off for a head injury. And it's just a substitution. Oh, he's shanked the kick again, unfortunately, and looks like York have gathered nicely. And Hex Campbell long clears his lines, but unfortunately not a very great distance for York there. Kicked out short. And Joe has actually gathered the match ball. Looks like Lancaster will go up the lineup.
That's the only touch of the ball I'm having.
Jace, we're getting a better view. And the Lancaster fans are gathering on the pitch by the looks of it. Not much space between the hooker throwing the ball into the line-out and the fans.
They are really encroaching on the pitch space here.
But it's just good atmosphere, you know. Lancaster have won it comfortably. Lancaster have gone for a maul here.
Driving the ball forward. Taken down by York. That's a really good ruck in here.
They're playing it down the blind side. Oh, and he's thrown it straight out of play. That's an unfortunate error there.
Tried to find someone and there was no one.
Lancaster have lost the ball now. It'll be a York line-out.
Man doing press-ups.
Warming up, you know.
Warming up.
The game. It's a scrum. It's a line-out.
It's a line-out, yeah.
Calling for a line-out. Scrum, but it is a line-out.
Yeah, really, really unfortunate mistake there. Yeah, just thought he could meet someone with that, but...
Just the pressure there as well. Again, they were taking too long. And so there was chat towards the referee, and they were taking too long. So York have been penalised now, and the ball has been turned over to Lancaster. Again, silly mistake. Considering how close Lancaster are, Lancaster opted for a scrum.
Lancaster in a really dangerous position here.
I think this is one of the first entries in a while they've been in the second in York's half.
Definitely.
Again, this is a really big opportunity for Lancaster to score here. Let's see if Lancaster can take this opportunity to take advantage of it.
Absolutely. So the scrum's just preparing now. And do you think they'll try and play it by down the blind side again? It doesn't look like it since they've got no players on that side. But
you don't know, the 8 might take it up and pick it up if he thinks he can beat the York winger. but the York's right side flanker, Matt Precious, is doing a really good job. The scrum half has taken out, he's putting into the wing. And it looks like Lancaster have the opportunity here.
Trying to drive forward.
Big tackle there by York.
Number 15 taken straight down.
And Lancaster have gathered nicely. They're running straight back into the breakdown.
Slightly dangerous pop there, where there was a definite risk of a knock-on, but Lancaster really secured it. Number 22 driving it forward. Number 8.
Handling error there. Looks like it's an advantage to York. And Lancaster have gathered, and they've taken a little box kick. I wonder if York gathered nicely, tackled by Lancaster. And looks like York have gathered the ball nicely, and it's York's possession again. Looks like Billy Charles is clearing the lines with another box kick.
It's coming straight to me.
That ball did nearly hit Joe and I.
Please don't try and hit the commentators.
Billy Charles, and it's... great bit of possession there. Good defensive work there from York.
See, if I didn't have a microphone in my hand, you know I would have caught it. You know I would have. but, you know, excuses.
It's Lancaster's line-out. Let's see if Lancaster can win this line-out and get possession again.
The good thing about almost being hit with a rugby ball is you get a really good view of the line-out, I guess.
It's a strong red kit.
Really looking good.
Let's have one comfortably. Not challenged very well by York there. And they're going upfield. They've made some really good meters there. Oh, and it's been turned over, and York have cleared it again.
It's a fantastic kick.
Straight into the right corner. I wonder if that's where York's been targeting it. I think that's part of their tactics and drills.
I think it definitely has been.
The ball went out of play, so it's a dead ball. It'll be a 22 dropout to Lancaster. So Lancaster will kick the ball back to York. And we'll see if it's a scrum. I wonder if there was an earlier infringement that I didn't see properly.
I didn't see it. I didn't see anything personally, but all I saw was a really, really strong kick, probably aided by the wind in York's favour. But yeah, really, pretty much from the halfway line all the way to the dead zone.
And Lancaster have an opportunity here to save the ball up again into York's half. It's been a really good half of rugby. Just a reminder, it's 10-0 to York. Still all to play for, though. Lancaster have ample opportunities to score. And it's a scrum to Lancaster on the halfway line. The ref has called it for an early engagement.
Really eager in these scrums here. I think it's York really trying to drive back after that embarrassing first scrum for them.
But they've been doing well otherwise. It's been a really good game.
100%, yeah, they've really brought it back.
Both sides have been playing very well. I've got to say, despite some handling errors, you know, not to
handling errors happen though, don't they?
Exactly, yeah.
They're really difficult to avoid. Because you can never predict where the ball's going, that's the, you know.
It's been a good game, but good game rugby there. I've been enjoying it. It's been great quality from both sides.
100%. And the sun is coming out, which is always welcome.
It's great to see how many people are here as well. I think this is probably one of the biggest games of the weekend.
Definitely.
Oh, the scrum. A strong scrum from Lancaster. They've not gathered very well from Lancaster, so York have got the ball.
York have regained possession, and he's fallen over himself. I think he was anticipating the tackle there a little bit.
Lancaster have actually turned it over. Lancaster have got the ball again.
Someone's headgear has come off, which people do need to be careful of.
Looks like the Lancaster winger is calling out for the right. There's a lot of space in the right wing. Looks like York have seen that, though.
Yeah, York Lancaster really filling in their right wing.
To the left. Oh, an unfortunate handling error again from Lancaster.
But not a knock-on. But referee stopped play.
Looks like
I didn't.
Did not see what happened.
No, I didn't see that. I'm sure the people watching might have seen it, but we didn't, unfortunately.
Looks like it's a... Lancaster, next opportunity to kick to the corner here and go for a driving maul slash line out into he's not got quite the meters there he wanted, but it's a good kick. Lancaster will have the line out though.
Another
Lancaster have got the line out though in an advantage position. Let's see if Lancaster can make anything of it.
So they are getting they're encroaching on the York try line here.
Strong word that,
encroaching. I like it. It's a good word.
Looks like Lancaster bring up an excellent opportunity here to get on the scoreboard.
These past 5 minutes, Lancaster really have been on the attack here, which is always nice to see. A bit of pushback there because York have been dominating Lancaster's half this so
Lancaster
far.
Lancaster won that line nicely. Oh, it looks like they're going down the blind side. he's gone straight back into the line-out where it's a bit crowded, but Lancaster...
Again, the second time a Lancaster player has gone back into their own scrum.
Oh, big hit here. They're making metres, though. Oh, he's been tipped up above the vertical, and he's dropped the ball. Lancaster have lost possession. Now it's back to York. York are now making metres on Lancaster. I wonder if York will clear their lines here. Lancaster have won a penalty, though. Lancaster had jackled very well there, received the ball. York did not release, so Lancaster have got possession again. Looks like Lancaster will go for... I don't know what's going here.
York side just making sure they're not offside.
Looks like the ref has... Looks like Lancaster have gone for the post. So it looks like Lancaster looking to get on the scoreboard here now. If they convert this penalty kick, it will be 10-3. So that means there's only one try game difference then.
Getting some points on the board.
It's an important move, I think. Lancaster is a safe option. Again, with the kicks and how windy it is and how blind us have been, probably a smart move not to go for the corner.
Definitely.
Again, high risk, high reward.
Yeah, so the wind is currently blowing the ball just to the left, so I think the kicker might have to accommodate for that.
We saw the guy, their kicker, training earlier and practicing earlier.
The wind has just picked up as well, which probably isn't good for a conversion. But sorry, a penalty kick.
Tight angle as well. We'll see how it does this.
Definitely. Balls in the air.
And it's a kick. He's successfully converted. Very good kick there.
Fantastic.
So the score is now 10-3 to Lancaster.
To York.
10-3. York still 7 points ahead.
Lancaster getting some points on the board.
Yeah,
though.
Just before the second half.
A drop of blood. You know, they might, hypothetically, obviously.
So York will be now returning the kick to Lancaster. So Lancaster again have an opportunity to take advantage of it.
Yeah, so a really strong kick from Lancaster there, following some less than ideal ones. But yeah, that one was really impressive.
Hector Campbell on to restart the game. He's kicked it deep into the right corner again, and Lancaster has gathered. Lancaster looking to run it upfield. Broken one tackle. Lancaster at the breakdown now.
Some really strong rook in there from Lancaster, giving up no ground. That was very impressive. Very, very stylish.
Lancaster have got the ball again during the breakdown. Again, not making many metres through this strong defensive line that York has.
You would have thought the goose step would have gotten them some more ground, but clearly not.
And Lancaster have grabbed the ball nicely. It looks like they're going for a box kick here to clear their lines. Yep, they have cleared their lines. Looks like... has gone straight
heads
out of play.
Straight onto the head of one of the York fans.
That is when you are this close to the game.
Certainly is.
I'm enjoying how many people are out here.
Absolutely.
The weather's holding up very nicely.
Definitely is. It doesn't... I'm not going to say that. I was about to predict the weather, but I am not, because that is not a good thing to do.
So York line out, well, expert. Again, been enjoying this quite a lot. York fans are there now, cheering them on. We'll see if York can take advantage of this line out.
Absolutely. Lancaster's line outs have been very, very good so far.
Just a points update on roseslive.co.uk. Lancaster are 155.5 points. York at 85.5. There's
Lancaster.
4 points up to play here. Lancaster are very close to
winning. Sorry. York are mauling the ball forward. They've won quite a few metres there from that maul. Ball's been presented.
And it's a crossfield kick to left corner.
To no one, unfortunately. I think the ball's going to go dead. It certainly has.
It was a good attempt there, Lou. It's good to see some of the exciting play.
Definitely.
A bit of a change up, you know. I do enjoy these sort of crossfield kicks, you know. Sort of a spectacle of rugby.
Yeah. Some risk playing, not just driving. You know, really trying to get some set pieces going. But unfortunately, there was no winger there to catch that fast enough, unfortunately, for York.
Advantage to York, so York have got possession again.
Definitely.
Looks like York will kick to the corner for a line out. And that was a very good kick from Billy Charles.
Really close to Lancaster's try line there.
Lancaster.
Very dangerous position.
Oh, apologies, we were wrong. Looks like
it's going to be
down to the dead zone. So
it's going to be a scrum down with Lancaster putting in, I believe.
Joe and I are on the opposite end of the field trying to observe. So apologies if we do make any mistakes in the calls here.
We'll try our best to correct them as we go along. But yeah, it's going to be a Lancaster put-in scrum down here. Still, though, York are in Lancaster's half.
They have been for most of this game.
Yeah, Lancaster had a really good spell there of being really, really aggressive and really attacking for about a good 10 minutes of this first half.
10 minutes of this half was all Lancaster, wasn't it?
Certainly was.
Unfortunately, we weren't lucky with them.
So it's been quite balanced, I must admit.
Yeah, it has been. And it's all York now, though, hasn't it?
Lancaster really driving this scrum. They've won some really good ground there.
Good tackle there by both York players. Lancaster still have possession, though. Creeping offside there.
That was a fantastic bit of footwork to get past the York.
Rush up. Oh, swatted down by Longers there. And it looks like the ref has called it. And it is Lancaster's ball again. Again, strong defensive work and line speed from York.
A really good interception there from York. But it was disregarded by the ref.
Lancaster have an opportunity to keep the ball downfield by their fly half now. And he's made some good meters again.
In the ditch once again, though.
Relegation deal. So I think we'll have a slight... Oh, no delay in play.
Fantastic.
The coach there has got a ball, and the game will be restarted soon.
And I'm sure someone will be going around with a little fish net, just trying to fish the ball out of the irrigation ditch.
Souvenir.
Absolutely. A very slimy souvenir.
Okay, so it's Lancaster line out here. It's thrown straight down the middle. Oh, and there's a bit of an error there. And York have got possession now.
Yeah, Lancaster have knocked it on.
And that's the half. Good first half of rugby, Joe.
What a fantastic half. It is 10-3 to York so far in this first half.
So I've been really enjoying this. I've got to say, what do you think needs to be done in the second half for Lancaster?
See, Lancaster need to do what they were doing about 10 minutes ago. They had a really good bit of play. No, because they had a really good bit at the start of the first half, and then York started dominating, and then they brought it back a little bit. They were really close to the try line, and just a few mistakes where I think they need to improve their ball handling. Obviously, you know, you can't help it to an extent, but they need to be a bit more careful with where they're popping the ball. Like there was an issue on the right hand side where, you know, the Lancaster player just threw it out of play. I think they really need to keep their eyes up. And try and find space between the York players, because this York defence is looking really, really strong today, even though Lancaster might have the more sizeable players in comparison on the whole. I think York, really, really strong tackles from York as well.
York currently 10-3 ahead.
Definitely.
There's 7 points in there. That's one try and a conversion. So what does York need to do now to sort of maintain their lead?
Play rugby.
Strong.
What do you think, Alexis? What do you think? I need your opinion.
I would say
expert opinion.
They've been doing really well. They've been playing the ball. Their line speed has been really good. I've been really impressed with how fast they're attacking, sort of like Lancastrian attackers. Again, I think the kicks downfield are really good. They're challenging the Lancaster backs. We've seen the speed of the York backs, and they are fast.
There has been some really good runs from Lancaster, though. There's been two or three where they've almost broken through, but just been caught. Really strong by, again, this really strong York defence, where they've been trying to find gaps, they've been trying to make runs, whereas York have been focusing more on trying to kick it forward and chase it, and really try and use the space on the pitch.
Yeah, I've got to say, I've been impressed with the quality of rugby we've seen today.
Definitely. Really strong scrums as well.
Yeah,
Lancaster,
really
I think it's an objective thing to say that Lancaster have been much stronger on the scrums here.
I don't know, mate, Jay. I think York... It might not be the size.
They've been holding their own, but Lancaster have been winning these scrums.
Yeah, I mean, again, the scrums are a hard part of the game. It's like devil's work, one might say. You know, it's sort of dark arts game. Don't really know what's going on. We can't really see what's going on. Again, really, really hard to say. But York can look good technically. Lancaster's still a very strong squad. I feel like Lancaster have a lot to play for, though. If they want to win this and stop the whitewash of men's rugby.
Definitely. But... I mean, if York keep playing as they are now, it's not looking good. But it's all to play for still in the second half.
Exactly. I mean, only a try and a conversion separates the teams. So.
Definitely. It hasn't been as scrappy as I predicted, however. It has been a pretty clean game. There was a few moments where it got a little bit touchy. Obviously, nerves and adrenaline have combined with the game of rugby to create some slightly tense moments, let's say, but on the whole it's been really composed from both sides, and quite respectful, which is always good to see in rugby.
I'm looking forward to seeing what happens in the second half. I feel like the second half is going to be possibly one of the best halves of rugby we've seen.
Definitely, especially as we get closer to the end, where obviously whoever's trailing will be desperately trying to break through their lines, and it'll get It'll get really really exciting then, I feel.
Well, Lancaster will be playing with the wind this half. Well, see if they get any advantage from that.
Definitely. It might improve their kicking, which has been objectively subpar so far.
But, I mean, again, student athletes, you know, you can't fold them in no, ways. No. And,
of course.
Again, I'm looking forward to seeing this game get restarted. Looks like the Lionos are getting ready into their positions. The ref is having a chat with some of the players, and it's looking like it's going to be a good second half of rugby. Just a reminder, the score is 10-3. Following on from this men's first games, it'll be women's ones. So it'll be a good game to watch that as well.
Fantastic.
The University of York women's team seconds won yesterday.
Certainly did.
With a results, and this can be a really good game as well.
So
I'm now getting ready to restart the game.
While York are getting into position, I'll just say that one of the Lancaster, Ben Hopi, one of the Lancaster players, after Roses last year, he kissed and bit the head coach. Bit feral, Ben, to be honest. But you know.
Thank you, Jay.
You're very welcome.
Fun facts. Right, looks like York are going to get ready to restart the game. The ref is just getting the lino ready. York fans have pushed through the barrier a little bit, so the lino is just asking them to take a step back. Similar on both sides, obviously. But yeah, should be restarting pretty soon now. The lino is just getting ready. The York fans are hyping up their players. And just looking like the restart will hold soon.
And I will start a little game for you all. One of the Lancaster players, number 5, has a Squidward tattoo. So let's see if you can spot it whilst he's playing. I don't know if he's on the pitch right now.
And the game has been restarted by York, taken nicely by Lancaster. Oh, and... There you are, in front of the kicker. Unfortunate restart there. Lancaster have gained possession.
Lancaster fans getting a bit rowdy.
Again, you don't often see in front of the kicker being called in rugby games, so an interesting start to the second half. Lancaster
scrum
have possession here, and it's their scrum.
Scrum down right on the centre line.
The Lancaster fans are singing loudly and proudly. Hopefully this will rouse up the Lancaster players.
Should I go join in? Should I have a little sing-song?
Go ahead, Joe. I'm sure you can give him some
Yeah, back,
as well.
Back in five. Give him some singing lessons.
There's going to be a big scrum to start off the second half.
First scrum of the second half. Let's see if anything changes up.
Lancaster have got the scrum ball. They've got the ball there very nicely. They're looking to run with it.
Ball's presented from the scrum and Lancaster moving the ball.
They've kicked downfield. Will it stay in play? Has it, but it's taking a nice bounce there as well.
Right into the irrigation ditch. That's the third time.
Lancaster this half.
Certainly is. The half has been only on for about a minute, though.
Yeah, I know. Apologies. Just excited, what can I say? Lancaster have got possession here, though.
I'm excited, too. It's a very exciting game. Very tense, but a lot to play for here. Lancaster could inch closer to the finish line, and Roses are with Roses on the hole. They are very close to absolute trashing York on home turf.
Which I'm sure they'll enjoy.
They certainly will.
Lancaster have won the line out. It looks like they're in an advantage position here.
Oh, really good line outs from Lancaster here.
Fortunate handling error there, but he's kicked downfield though. We'll see how York's winger holds us. Oh, he's taking a step there. Oh, he's been driven back though to his own try line.
If Lancaster can ruck over here.
York have decided to run it from their own try line. He's made 2 metres though.
Really good bit of driving there from number 19.
Lancaster are challenging again. Looks like York are playing out from their try line. It's smart. It's an interesting move, though. Often you'll see the sort of defending team for their own try line to clear their line.
Number 4 needs to get onside there.
Nice box kick. Will it stay in play? Oh, it's unfortunately
it's gone
out
once again.
Ditch again.
That's the fourth time. 4-0 in the irrigation ditch.
But like, it's been a strong half so far off from Lancaster. I know it's
definitely.
But
they've come back fighting though. They've definitely come back swinging. Yeah. But York are driving it back now towards Lancaster, but they're still in a dangerous position where if Lancaster can win this line out, you know, they've got some really good space here to make some dangerous plays.
York have been really strong defensively. They've been very defensive sound. Lots of strong lines.
100%.
Again, you have to credit York. It takes a lot of courage to run it from your own try line up to 22.
Definitely.
Again, just shows you that York are confident on the ball. Lancaster have still got ample opportunities to bring back a game, though. And we'll see if any tries scored anytime soon. Looks like we're still waiting for the ball to be returned. And the ball is now being presented for the line-out.
So Lancaster putting in with this line-out?
Just a reminder, the score is 10-3 to York. So that's one try and a conversion for Lancaster to tie the game.
Lancaster just winning that.
He's been kicked out of the breakdown.
Lancaster driven back there, but still trying to inch forward.
Yeah, refs called it. To Lancaster there as the ball was kicked out of the breakdown illegally. And looks like Lancaster have an opportunity here to. They've opted for the scrum. Oh. No, they've gone for post. Yeah, smart move. If they convert this, it'll be 10-6. So only one try and game difference.
Just crawling forward towards the towards York's 10 points.
Yeah, a silly mistake there from York, but Lancaster have taken opportunity here.
Definitely.
Lancaster can convert this to bring the game ever closer. As you can hear, the trumpet is being...
So it's a bugle.
A bugle, I do apologize.
It's a bugle. He's quite good, that bugle player, actually. I heard him earlier. He's very good.
Some little notes and tunes.
Absolutely.
Was it Toots? I don't know. Well, it looks like Lancaster getting ready for his penalty kick here.
Is he Cristiano Ronaldo or is he Peter Crouch, as I said yesterday?
I think more like the Johnny Sexton or Johnny Wilkinson. We'll see. It's great to see, though, the sportsmanship and camaraderie here. When everyone's expecting the kicker. And he's nudged it.
That looks promising. Glides right through the posts.
The ref and Lino, it looks like he has not converted. It looks like it'll be 22 dropout to York. Oh,
that looked like it went through from where we were standing.
Deceptive angles. But it's University of York now to return the kick to Lancaster. It's a strong kick down to York's left wing. Oh, unfortunately not taken very well by Lancaster there.
Still picked up. But
strong tackle by York, and Lancaster still have possession here. And there's the fans there cheering on, a bit of a voice break there. They are arguing for Lancaster to dish out wide. Lancaster do have the ball though. And
trying to maul forward. They're not using the space on this left hand wing, however.
So much
space. As previously pointed out.
Potentially a crossfield kick could open up the game. We'll see what happens though. It's a penalty though, and York have one possession again. It looks like the Lancastrian defender was not able to roll away, thus not releasing the ball.
So York penalty, and it's going to be a scrum down, I believe.
Scrum to York. Again, a lot of scrums this game, a lot of set pieces.
100%.
Forwards are going to feel quite tired and fatigued.
Yeah.
We'll see if this progresses through the game and see how they
Especially with the aggression level of these scrums.
Yeah, and how physical the game has just been in general.
Definitely. A lot of these tackles have been very full on. Yeah. You can hear the contact between the two men colliding.
How would you cope with this sort of game, Joe?
I would probably curl up in a ball in the corner and cry, Alexis, to be honest.
Jay. Looks like York have put this ball in. And the scrum is being wheeled again. Lancaster have been really strong in the scrums.
Definitely.
The ball's been played very nicely there by Will Carter and Max Buckley.
Really, really smooth there, play. But a fantastic tackle from Lancaster.
Yeah, breaking through that sort of set play there. The York still have ball. Lancaster turned over.
Just didn't release the ball there. He was on the ground. I think they were trying to trying to jackal, but
Lancaster have an excellent opportunity here to kick for the corner. We'll see if Lancaster can make this work here. Oh, and it's a strong kick from Lancaster to the corner. Lancaster have an excellent opportunity here for a line out and potentially a maul over to score in the corner.
A refreshing break from some previously less than ideal kicks for Lancaster, but that was fantastic. They've got some really good space and a really good opportunity to find a gap between this really strong York defence and Alexis almost just fell over a rope there.
Lancaster have got a line out here, and it's not been contested by York. It's gone to the back though, and Lancaster got a little set play here. They gathered nicely.
Really, that number 8, fantastic run there.
Making some good meters though.
Just bouncing off the York defence.
And Lancaster have won this breakdown. Oh, an unfortunate pass, but it's been gathered nicely by Lancaster still.
Really well recovered.
Running through the middle. Lancaster playing out to the right wing. Again, looking a bit everywhere.
And number 13 just finding space.
Lancaster now playing it down the left wing. They've got numbers.
Fantastic bit of set play here from Lancaster. Some really great passing, really keeping the ball moving. But the referee stopped the play.
Lancaster.
Very, very close to the try line as well.
Gabe, the University of York captain, is being talked to by the referee. I don't know what the friction is. This is why we should have referee marks, you know. It'd be great to hear what's been going on and being said. But the ref is having some words with the players. I think it was James Blackwell lifting the player above the vertical. Yes, again, you can't lift the player above the vertical.
Yeah, it's going to be a booking.
York are now down to 14 men. Lancaster have ample opportunity here to do a good job here. And that's a really important position. Well, it's playing second row, so we'll see what happens with the scrums here. An unfortunate yellow. Again, you can't lift the players above the vertical. It's all about player safety these days. If this was the 1980s, I'm sure it would be allowed. You know, it would be applauded.
Yeah, but not today, not today. Safety is key in the game of rugby. It's a dangerous game anyway.
Exactly. It's a physical game, and there's no need for any extra dangers there.
I think Lancaster are definitely very confident with these scrums.
There's now one of their second rows have gone off for York.
Very true.
So someone is having to
step in, yeah.
And there's 14 men. Looks like Lancaster are getting ready for the scrum. We'll see how they do. Lancaster are pushing.
Driving forward.
The scrum has collapsed, though. And Lancaster still have the ball. Again, not a great pass out to centre, but Lancaster making moves here. Again, running towards the scrum. So there's still numbers there. Lancaster do have an advantage again. Lancaster dishing out to left wing.
Trying to find some space here. Really good pop there.
He's being held up. It's a scrum. Moore
yeah.
has gone down into a breakdown. They're making metres every time they're carrying the ball here.
Inching closer and closer to the try line. Just trying to find that gap.
Just a reminder, it is 10-6. Oh, the ball has popped up. Lancaster still have possession here. The crowd is very tense. We're just being mindful not to get away with the camera. Oh, it looks like it was knocked on there. I don't know what the ref's saying. No, it's not been knocked on. It's been knocked backwards.
Ref's happy with that.
And Lancaster creeping ever so close to the York try line.
Really, really.
Just a reminder, this is a one try game. So if Lancaster score here, they will have the advantage and they will be ahead. Lancaster are creeping forwards and forwards.
They've definitely come out strong from the south. They've found some space on this left wing.
I can't see if Lancaster scored there. I think they
haven't.
Held up
no, they haven't.
Lancaster
have
scored in the left wing. That is now 11-10 to Lancaster. What a game of rugby we have in our hands.
What
here.
A fantastic bit of set play from Lancaster. And they've changed the lead here.
And that is Lancaster ahead now. Again, shows you how quick this game can turn around.
Absolutely.
Lancaster scoring position there in the left wing. It's going to be a hard kick, angles-wise. I wonder how they'll do. Again, just a reminder, is currently...
We've got some different information here where it might not be a try. Sorry, please just bear with us. Obviously, we didn't quite see because we're on the same half as. So it was a try because they're taking a conversion. Conversion is pretty far on the wing. It's a pretty steep angle.
Game remains 11-10 to Lancaster. Unfortunately, missing conversion.
So it's now 9-10. So they know I'm just in.
Hey,
so, apologies, you got the score wrong.
Got the score wrong. No one told us. It is still 10-8 to York somehow.
Again, I think we've somehow our maths got muddled up there.
Yeah. We are not maths students. We are politics and history.
Apologies to the...
As you can probably tell.
So York are still ahead. Again, apologies for the missed score. Again, if we had a scoreboard, it would be good.
Yeah, it would be good. Or you know... referee talk back or yeah. Something like that, but no.
Apologies all.
We are charged with maths ourselves.
But it's 10-8.
With York in the Lancaster half with scrum. Is it Lancaster putting in there? Or is it York?
It's a Lancaster putting in. And the scrum has been collapsed, and York have got possession again. York have played it quick, but the ref has held it up because of the players still on the floor. Again, player safety is paramount here.
Definitely.
And
referee's holding up play just for a second.
And looks like Lancaster will go back 10 metres. And York have an opportunity here to kick the post. I don't know what's going on. I think they're having a discussion about what they're going to plan on here. Again, the score is 10-8. Apologies for miscalculations. York have gone for a tap and go here. Oh, it's a big collision there.
Very, very big collision.
Taking two players out there. York still have possession here.
There was no hesitation there. Straight in.
Looks like they're going to play down the right wing. Matt Pressure is making some good meters there.
Really fun.
Pumping his feet through. And looks like York is still here. Pumping down the right wing. Looks like there's a good build-up play here. There's some space.
Really fantastic bit of play on the wing.
He's stepped through three people here. He's been tackled and he's been brought down.
Feet away. Feet away from the Lancaster try line.
Looks like York playing quite a fast ball here. Throwing it into the centres. They're playing again. Looking up to left wing. Will Carter's tackled. He's been brought back. He's still making metres though. He's gone ahead. York have a lot here. They're going back down to the right wing. Gabe, the captain there, being tackled. Still making some good metres. And they're making
York
more metres.
York doing really well to drive through this Lancaster defence here.
Just shy of the post there. The winger's calling out for the left on the right wing. Will Carter's going through. And he's scored!
What a fantastic try.
That is now 15-8 to York.
It is 15-8. We have confirmed it.
And
it is
still a whitewash, rugby-wise, to the University of York. A strong try there by Will Carter. And
really found some space there. But I think, to be honest, that was a little bit inevitable unless they fouled there. Because they made some really fantastic meters. You know, the Lancaster defence there was just kind of bouncing off the York players and just managed to find that gap and scored a really fantastic try there. But they're just leaned up to the conversion now. Pretty clean under the post.
Charlie Mayhew is going to kick this conversion. They've rushed him.
Yeah, fantastic conversion there.
17-8 to University of York. Lancaster have all to play for here. And it's looking good though. York comfortably in the lead at the moment.
Definitely. They've got quite a sizable margin here, but still all to play for here in the second half. But it is it's looking like a strong York player today.
Lancaster have reset. They've kicked it deep down into the right-hand side.
Is it going to stay in? It's gone out.
So York will get possession again. Unfortunate error there from Lancaster. But York have got the ball again. And again, York doing really well as well.
Definitely. Some really strong attacking play there from the backs. Has that man who got sent off come back on yet? So they've done that with 14 men? Yeah, so with that yellow card at 11:28, I'm not too sure if he's back on yet. He's not back on. So they've done that with 14 men, essentially.
So I'm definitely going to be buying myself some of that. Well, there's a coach at 2 o'clock.
They might have done it with 14 men. They also might not have.
We could get on that one. What are the people going to get
on that one? Nice one, Alexis. He is not back on. We have confirmed it. But yeah, it's going to be a York scrum down right in the right to the centre of the pitch. Who's it putting in?
Billy Charles
putting in.
And Billy Charles playing here now to the right wing. Max Buckingham's got it here.
Really great bit of play there, finding
the
gap.
Nicely. Oh, an unfortunate interception there for York, but really well done from Lancaster.
Very
Gabbed
good
it nicely,
interception.
And it's now Lancaster's ball.
Lancaster did really well there to break that play up and get the advantage there.
Lancaster now playing it down the left wing. A nice handoff there. And a big tackle there from York's fullback. Taking down the big man. Lancaster still in possession of the ball.
Huh?
Oh, there is an injury, unfortunately, though. On this. York have got possession now. Max Buckin breaking off tackles. Chris Totti now with the ball, stepping the Lancaster defender. Unfortunately, knocking on, and the ref is holding it up because of an injury that we've seen earlier.
So there is a couple of injuries from the Lancaster side here. Medics just running on, spraying some breezy stuff.
How this game has been,
definitely.
Setting in, a bit of lactic acid going on, and it's been a really good game of rugby though. And looks like York are doing some substitutes for their front row. Getting a fresh front row on is really important in this latter end of the game. You know, the scrums are really important.
Definitely, fresh bit of energy for the final push to maintain their lead here. But still, Lancaster could bring this back. But Lancaster's back trailing what is it? 7 points now? Is it? My maths is terrible. 9 points. Yeah, because it's 17-8. So 9 points. So you know, a try conversion and then maybe penalty kick could put them in the lead. But yeah, even though they are trailing, it has been a really, really strong bit of play from Lancaster.
Definitely. Both sides have been picked all in. It's been one for the crowd, you know, one for the neutrals, one for the rugby noises. Everyone's enjoying themselves, and it's been a great day of the rugby.
I know, I'm having a great time. Are you having a great time?
I'm having a great time.
And the weather has held out so far. Whether it continues is up to whoever controls the weather, the government, I don't know.
It's fun.
But yeah.
The
sun has been shining on Rose's this weekend, which is always nice.
York have got a big scrum here. Lancaster have got it. Again, being wheeled. And Lancaster have lost it. York have won it in a very advantageous position. They're passing it out of the left wing. Purvis out to himself. Oh, big bump off there from York.
Bouncing off
the
Lancaster player.
And he's going towards the try line. He's out to the wing. Can York score here?
Lancaster
held it up very nicely.
Are regaining their defensive
work from Lancaster. Oh, it's going to be a big push. And it looks like it's being held up on the try line. York still have an opportunity to score here. It's been held up and it'll be a scrum.
Very, very close to the try line.
Very exciting play from the University of York. Lancaster still doing very well defensively. The University of York making their motion, these set plays in the backs, you know.
That was a really good start from Billy Charles there. The scrum was very good because to be fair, with Lancaster scrum being so strong, it was really good that they won that one, and well for York, and managed to really make the most of that, but held up by.
They
couldn't find that gap, I think. I just think they couldn't find that gap in the Lancaster defence. Just the momentum really, really slowed down, and they were held up, and now it's going to be a scrum with York putting in.
This is a really good opportunity for York to score here as well, and sort of turn there in the coffin here.
And
margins here are getting bigger for York,
and it's score. And not looking good.
Really strong scrum from Lancaster. York have collapsed there. York has somehow managed the possession still. They're looking at left wing down the blind side. Will Carter's got it. He's going all the way. York has scored again, and it is looking all York this half.
So it's 22 points to Lancaster 7. It is a very dominant 8. See, I told you. I'm certainly not a math student.
22-8, just for those.
22-8.
The Lancaster fans are not out there. They're still in this game. Lancaster, an unfortunate.
Alexis, can I say something? And you might punch me in the face.
Oh no.
It is 22-8. On the 22-8, because.
Oh, that was.
Awesome. I
love doing
that. Apologies to all the listeners back here.
Beth Hardesty, our producer, wants to punch me in the face.
Right, well,
I wouldn't blame her.
Looks like Charlie Mayhew will try and convert this from a very tight angle. He's a very good kicker, though. He's done a lot for college rugby, you know, James College and stuff like that. He's a very good kicker. And, we'll see
James College?
And we'll see how he does. Lancaster fans getting a bit rowdy. They're charging down the kick. It's a tight angle. Has he got this?
It looked like it from here.
No, he hasn't.
No, he hasn't.
He's missed that, unfortunately. And the game remains 22-8 to York.
22-8.
It's a hill to climb for Lancaster, but they've got an opportunity here to give it back to York in the dying moments of this game. Just a reminder, 22-8.
And that is not 7:40. 22-8.
And we We'll see how Lancaster can retaliate here. Following this match, it'll be the University of York women's versus Lancaster women's ones. Matt Precious has made some good meters there, taking it nicely. University of York still in possession here. And University of York looking very confident now.
They're really managing to glide through and really push on these mauls. Like, that is a really strong maul.
They're making some very good meters for York. York getting out of their own half pretty quickly. And now they're down on the left wing. Back in Lancaster's half. Lancaster have got the ball though, due to not releasing the ball. And Lancaster's taking it quickly.
And it's held up. Oh, out of play. What fantastic
big tackle.
Tackle
into the York crowd. Looks like tensions are high now. Some words being given from both sides.
I must admit, though, that. I must admit the referee I think has been very fair in this match. I've agreed with the decisions he's made.
Thank you to the Yorkshire RFU for sending these refs down.
100%.
Raise the weekend.
There has been a big campaign, especially on the York campus, of respect the ref, because there were some issues previously with giving the ref some lip. But I'm glad to see that you know, that sort of thing has not happened this match.
And it's really good to see that everyone respects the refs. And,
definitely.
Lancaster have got the penalty here. Looks like Lancaster have opted for kick towards the corner. Hopefully they can make some good meters here. They have indeed made some good meters. So hopefully
fantastic
we'll see
kick.
A good lineup from Lancaster.
Has it ended up in the irrigation ditch? I don't think
it
so.
Has indeed. It's inevitable if you're kicking towards that area because the irrigation ditch is huge. We love the 22
and I would not be want to be the person who goes fishing around in there.
Bugle has been sounded. Lancaster are primed and ready for this line-out.
They've been really strong on their line-out so far. I don't think they've lost a line-out here.
They're waiting for a ball because the ball is still in the irrigation ditch.
Yep.
And the game is delayed.
Someone's going for a swing.
The ball has been brought out of the irrigation ditch. I think this is quite fundamentally grassroots rugby, you know.
Definitely.
And the ball is now being ready.
You don't get that at Twickenham.
And the ball has been thrown into line-out. Oh, it's been taken very well by Lancaster in the back of the scrum. It's been held down, so he's still able to go there.
There's fantastic line out.
Lancaster have opportunities here.
Bit of a scrappy tackle there, but refs keeping play moving.
The ball is being presented again once by Lancaster.
Great ruck from Lancaster there.
Opportunity here to go to York's try line.
Again, Lancaster trying to drive through. Wingers stood scratching their nose. Not really being utilised in this play.
Big hit there. Stopping any Lancaster meters being made. Lancaster calling it out for wide. The right wing's looking empty. A
really loose tackle
and
there.
Been pushed out of play. Oh, and it's getting a bit of handbags over there as well.
Yeah. Really poor tackle. That was a very, very high pass there.
It was an advantage to Lancaster, so Lancaster still had possession of the ball.
Certainly was.
And I can just see in yonder the University of York women's team looking like they're getting ready for the game following on from this.
Are you looking forward to it?
I am indeed. Should we go get a rugby?
As am I.
Looking like it could still be a whitewash, rugby terms wise. And still 22-8 to York.
Did you like my previous joke about that, Alexis, or was it not appreciated?
I don't know. I mean, is it the time and place?
I think it is. You've got to keep it light. It's an intense game, you know. You've got to have some brevity.
Move from Lancaster there, just underneath the posts. And we'll see if Lancaster can score here.
The wingers looking prepped and ready to find a gap. But I think they're going to try and maul it through.
Over. And the ball's not being presented. Okay, Lancaster is now getting ready for a move here.
Ball's been presented. Ball's away.
And it's fast play. A strong tackle again from York. Stopping Lancaster in their moves.
And Hawks seem to be an unstoppable force here with their tackles.
Another strong tackle from York. Lancaster not making any meters there. They are just inches away from York's try line though.
Lancaster seem to be inching closer, but mostly just moving sideways, moving horizontally.
The right wing is completely empty though. Lancaster can maybe take advantage of that. But it looks like they're going to run it forward again. And it's been held up
Lancaster.
Again. It's been pushed backwards. They're making negative meters there.
Lancaster really not utilising their wings here, just trying to drive it through.
Looks like Lancaster's aiming for a penalty here, maybe a penalty try. But looks like Lancaster's got the ball again. Cut short again. Lancaster edging closer to the right wing. And the ball is knocked on. It's a yellow card to York.
Once again. Is that 13 men now?
No, there's 14 men. Okay. So another yellow to York, and it looks like York are ready to tap and go. Again, not too sure what the yellow card or the impact was.
No, I wasn't sure either. Well, yeah, again, back to respect the ref. No problems there, just accepted it and moved on, which is always nice to see. Lancaster again, still trying to drive through.
Have scored.
They have scored the try.
It is
22-13. We got our maths right this time. Did we, Beth? Fantastic. 22-13. Still to York, but Lancaster still obviously have their conversion. But yeah, what a great bit of play. Could they have utilised their wings a little bit more? They had loads of space on that right-hand side.
They could have, but if it's underneath the post, then why not? But it looks like there's a bit of a miscommunication here. They're looking for the tee, and the ball boy, the waterman, is running as fast.
And the medic. He is the ball boy, waterman. Well, yeah, ball boy, waterman, and medic.
He's the tee up.
A jack of all trades.
Laughs and giggles there from Lancaster. We'll see if they can convert here. It looks like Lancaster pushing back. A little comeback here, but is it too little too late?
Possibly. But, you know, they're still in a dangerous position here. So I think we're approaching the latter parts of the second half now.
Try and run this down. Oh, he's creeping!
Wide through. No, just
wide.
Was it? I swear, I could have sworn that went through from our angle, but it has not.
Again, deceptively looking like it went through from our angle, but yeah, it's still. Oh, and the medic has dropped all his stuff in the middle
He's a busy man. He's got to treat people. He's got to run the tees, and he's got to feed people water. So, you know, big up anyway. Even if he has dropped his bag.
We started it. It's 22-13, just a reminder.
So York looking to restart here.
It's a strong kick. The wind has affected it a little
certainly
bit.
Certainly has.
And it's been taken nicely, and it's been taken out of play. York line out.
Very good bit of play there. Very good tackle into the
York fans.
Yeah.
And you see York line out. I feel like York will try and seal this game out, you know.
Definitely. I think the next try for York will definitely be the final nail, so to speak.
We'll see if Lancaster can score again.
Lancaster are looking very, very dangerous this half,
Lancaster have to do some fancy moves there, and York have won the lineout.
Almost.
Is saying that it was not thrown straight there, so
not happy with that.
Yeah, as well. So the ball will be turned over to Lancaster. It'll be Lancaster scrum. It's been a good game of rugby, though. I've been enjoying it, and it's been holding out as well.
I've been thoroughly enjoying myself. Very exciting, very aggressive, and I think it's going to get more aggressive as the game goes on. Yeah, definitely.
Post-match celebrations.
Definitely.
I love it when people rush into the field, and it's nice to see that. You know, good scenes and stuff.
And I'm sure they'll be in the back in the Charles by the end of the day for a little post-match celebration here in York.
Be that non-alcoholic or alcoholic beverage.
Absolutely not. Only orange juice.
And Lancaster have won the scrum very dominantly, so they're preparing themselves, and it looks like they're doing a kick downfield.
Really strong kick there from Lancaster.
As well. Oh, and York have done some butt hands there. Oh, and it's playing to the whistle. Oh. And, there's some handbags going on there now.
A little bit of rough and tumble going on. It's not what we want to see. It's not what we want to see.
Just a reminder, York are down to 14 men, though, so they really can't take any risks here.
Absolutely not. So the referee's not happy with that. And if he's thinking of booking, that will not be good for the York side.
Crowd noises. The crowd are living up and wild at the moment. As tensions are high. We are stood with Lancastrian fans. And they're looking forward to this now.
Obviously, we are impartial, so you know we shouldn't have any problems here today.
Lancaster scrum in the York half. Remember, York are down to 14 men, so there's opportunity here for Lancaster to score.
So a really strong scrum there from Lancaster. ball was about to be presented.
Huge scrum from Lancaster there.
York just crumbling.
York.
Number 13 trying to find some space on the wing, but brought down by York. Nice. Great pop there.
Oh, it's been a lovely kept in play there.
What a fantastic set play from Lancaster. They're going to try and drive it down the middle.
The right wing is looking empty out there.
But they haven't got any players on the wing. Number 25 is inching towards it, but...
Oh, and it's looking a bit argy-bargy now.
York's trying to fill in their right wing.
Strip the ball.
He was not on the ground just yet.
Ball's being dished out to left wing again. Strong line to me from York.
Very strong tackle.
Lancaster have lost all impetus there now.
The momentum here is really really bogged down. I think we're going to start getting in the trenches.
The York, they're making it. They've used the right wing. There's space on the right wing.
Fantastic use of space there from Lancaster.
They've lost there. Again, strong defensive work from York in their black and yellow strip. York still defensively quite sound.
Definitely.
Lancaster now playing out to left wings.
Lancaster really using
big meters. Some big collisions there.
Lancaster really using the space here, which is good to see.
Looks like Lancaster are going down the left wing again. Oh, big hit there. Take it down nicely. Lancaster have still got space out here on the left wing.
Keeping the ball moving, trying to find space. Well. It's missed number 23, but number 11 has... Can we see it? Ball's been presented and they're going to start moving it back towards the centre. What's happening there?
I'm not too sure.
He tackled himself.
Lancaster now playing out to the right wing. And people are calling out for the right wing. Look at the right. They've gone for a crossfield kick. Can they pay this off here? Oh, it's been taken badly by York, though. And it was last touch by York, so it will be a Lancaster in possession again. It's been taken back to the infringement on the left wing. It'll be a to Lancaster.
Lancaster keeping it close to home for York.
Love to see the crossbow kick, so that's a bit of spark to the game. And you know, it just shows Lancaster still wanting, you know, and there's the next option here for Lancaster to score.
Definitely. They're still hungry for some points. And you know, who knows? It might be a miracle comeback.
We shall see.
We shall see.
It's still a whitewash for York Roses wise rugby terms, even sorry. And Lancaster hill ball. They're running up forward.
I think the rest of the sports here at Roses will have to take a leaf out of the York Rugby's book in how to beat Lancaster because so far York. Not been the best.
It's been brought back for a late infringement again. Oh, the ref has called it. I wonder what. Is that another card? The ref has brought the University of York captain.
Go on,
it looks like it might be another yellow card for York. The ref is talking about the massive amount of the penalties that York have had now. This will probably be a team penalty, a team card, so it won't be a single person who's done this wrong.
Yeah.
We shall see. Reminder, York has 14 men still.
So reaching for his booking card, I think.
I think he just had some stern words with University of York's captain there.
Bit of a finger wag. Lancaster with the ball presented, trying to drive it through York's defence, but brought down immediately. York driving them back in the mall.
Yeah. Oh, a big tackle there from York, pushing the Lancashires back. Again, can't really see what's going on, unfortunately. York have turned over.
What a fantastic
turnover there for York.
Right on their try line as well.
Scoring opportunity for Lancaster.
It's been quashed by York.
Indeed it has. Important turnover there for York. Lancaster will be kicking themselves and not converting that.
I think if we can't see the play, we can always tell, because as soon as that happened, the York side on the other side of the pitch erupted with glee.
And the ball has been kicked out. Not very far though.
It has hit a tent.
Moving by archery.
Probably not the best to be kicking a rugby ball at someone with a bow and arrow.
It is all blank. So again, we're having a bit of an issue here with ball because the ball is on the opposite side of the field.
So it's going to be a York line out here.
Lancaster really need to win this line out here.
So the ball.
Set penalty to Lancaster now, and Lancaster are opting for a scrum.
Very interesting. They are quite close, and a conversion hood is possible from that distance. But I think they're more comfortable with the scrum here since they've been so dominant previously.
They want to get points on the board here. I think with how tight the game is, looks like the ref is talking to the York players in terms of when the impeachment is happening. No, impeachment,
infringement. They're not being impeached just yet. I don't think any of them are in their high office.
But it's important that York do not give away any more penalties here, considering they've been warned by the referee multiple times.
Definitely.
And Lancaster have it all to play for here. Lancaster really need to score if they want to even bring this game to a close now.
And Lancaster are really hungry for these points now.
It's a big scrum from Lancaster. They've won that comfortably. Yeh has picked it up. He's dished out to the scrum half. Scrum half's dished out to inside centre. It's down the right wing.
Great movement there.
He's dished out again. There's numbers. Try from Lancaster.
Try.
The right wing there. The coach is on the field. Lancaster brought it back. It's now 22-18. This game has just got close. What a game we have on our hands, Joe.
Very, very impressive. Very good movement of the ball from there from Lancaster. And, you know, that was some really good play, and it was rewarded with a try.
If they convert this, it will be a two-point game. Jane,
very
close. Is a historic game. One for the history books, maybe.
Definitely, definitely.
It's been very exciting. I've got to say, I'm very happy to be with you, Jay, commenting over this. It's been an exciting game, and I'm glad we're here.
Absolutely.
In this glorious sunshine.
Well, yeah, sunshine's a strong word.
Yorkshire sunshine,
that is much more apt, I think.
See if the Lancastrian can convert. It's a very tough angle from the furthest wingers.
Very, very wide.
And I know I can see the York fans giving it large to him.
He's basically stood in their stance, which is not good for him.
And he's gone wide, so the game remains 22-18. And it is all to play for as York kick it back to Lancaster.
One more try for Lancaster, though, and they are in the lead. How exciting is that?
It is a game for the neutrals, the Rugby Noises, and the fans back at home. Just a reminder, there's one try that separates the teams here. And I've got to say, Jay,
I think this has put the pressure back on York, definitely.
Charlie Mayhew has kicked it down to the left wing again. The wind is affecting. Oh, it's been nicely taken from York there. York have possession again in Lancaster's half, and it's been played very well here. York are making some good meters into Lancaster's half now.
Really bringing back the aggression here.
It's a nice play there. It's a
brilliant handoff.
Oh, and it's been stripped out. Lancaster possession. Will they make anything from it? And he's been knocked on. The ref has played.
Referee's not happy with that knock on. He's calling a scrum. The original knock on. There was a first and a second, and he's brought it back. And it's going to be a Lancaster put in.
It is getting scrappy now, though. It's not surprising.
Definitely.
You can tell. Tensions are building up.
You can tell what comes to the close here.
All to play for, really. All to play for.
Very impressive comeback here. I said about a miracle comeback earlier, and it seems possible now. It didn't seem possible then, but it's definitely on the cards. So again, all to play for still in the closing moments of the second half. Let's go, Lancaster
fans.
Someone says
cheering them on, as you can imagine. Lancaster have the scrum here,
and for an away force, this has been a really impressive showing.
And the scrum's been wheeled, so Lancaster have got the penalty there. It's another mistake from York. It is getting quite dangerous for York here now, though.
Definitely
Lancaster
is.
Can look to optimise and take advantage of this mistakes. Lancaster are opting to kick it to us by the looks of it, so hoping we would not be hit by this.
I will.
They've switched sides, they've gone for the right wing, so luckily we're safe.
I was limbering up there to run.
Has he kicked it out though? They've kept it in play, so he's not actually been able to kick it out, and Dork have the opportunity to return this kick. Oh, it's been nicely handed off there.
Very good handoff.
Just a reminder now, York have 15 players on the field. Oh, Longhurst, who got set off earlier, has made an excellent dart down the line. And a big tackle outplay into York fans. And there's some handbags going on now as tensions have risen.
That was a fantastic run there from York.
We don't condone handbags. We'd love to see this sort of atmosphere in there.
Absolutely. So the York, I think that's the Lancaster women's team, just making their way over to the far pitch, preparing for their game next. But yeah, it's going to be a Lancaster line out.
And we have a Lancaster player down. We will see the water boy / medic / tea carrier is running onto the pitch. I guess he is the 16th man, as you might say.
Absolutely. And just as a distinction, he does not carry hot beverages. He carries teas like the golf teas for the rugby
ball.
Thank you
for the clarification there, Joe.
You're very welcome. He might have a thermos in his bag. I'll have to ask him after the game.
He knows, maybe with deep heat as well.
I'm sure he does.
It's looking good though. This is a really exciting second half of rugby. And
definitely.
There's, again, reminder, all to play for as the score is 22-18.
You could tell the York fans were getting riled up there as York made a really promising run there. Brought straight out of play by the Lancaster, strong Lancaster tackle.
It's a Lancaster line out in their own half, deep into their own half.
Let's see if they can continue their trend of really strong line outs here.
Oh, and it's oh, they have not. By York!
They have
Lancaster
not.
Have lost that line out in a very dangerous position. York have managed to gather possession here.
York needs to present that ball.
It looks like the York players are appealing to the ref, but Lancaster have won the breakdown there.
Again, Lancaster's strong ruck there, just stealing the ball from that tackle.
Looks like Lancaster, they're going to kick it downfield. Again, it's not a strong kick. It's taken nicely by York there. An unfortunate pass there. Very flat pass, but the liner has not called it. Looks like York are now playing with the wings. Some strong footwork there, but Lancaster have not made a move anywhere. He's been held back. The ref's asking for the ball to be used there, and it's been brought down into the centre. Lancaster looking very strong here. They want it. They're really wanting this game to be there now. Precious has the ball. Oh, and a big collision there.
I'm sure you heard it on the Atmos mics there.
Oh, and it's been stripped. Lancaster have won the ball back. And it's been held up. The tackle's been made. Lancaster possession here. It's all Lancaster right here, right now.
Fantastic.
Like kick downfield.
And that was a brilliant kick there.
Oh, and it's taking a nice bounce for Lancaster. Oh, and it's been held in nicely from York there. And it looks like York are going to clear their lines. And the kick has been straight out into the irrigation ditch. It's looking.
Someone's going fishing. Someone's going fishing. But yeah.
I think this is what they call liquid duet. It's looking good here. Tensions are high.
Certainly is.
Now, as you can imagine, this game, how intense it's been.
Very.
We're starting to feel this in their legs. Again,
it's been a very mobile game as well. It's really moved back and forth and got some really dangerous moments.
Looks like the water boy is not needed as he's run onto the pitch.
And turned around.
He's had some good meters today, though, I'm sure.
He certainly has. He's been getting his steps in. I'm sure his Fitbit will be very happy with him this
Lancaster
evening.
Lancaster have the line out here. Will they win this? They have not. York have won it again. Lancaster making another fatal error. But Lancaster turned over. Oh, the ref has said that the ball was not thrown straight into the line out, so it will be a York line out.
I'm sure that's fantastic news for York there.
York scrum. Lancaster making some really silly errors here, particularly in York's half, needing only a try to.
Obviously, fatigue and.
Joe, have you got anything to say?
I've got lots of things to say, obviously, because it's me. So, if anyone's watching from the mainstream now, welcome. The score is 22-18 so far in favour of York. So, it is very, very close. One try difference. And it's now a York scrub after a very silly Lancaster.
Easily, and Precious is running with it. Lancaster have.
York finding some really good space there. Tackle from Lancaster.
Oh, they're running upfield now. Passing down the right wing. Right in front of us. Oh, man, he has got the ball.
Fantastic break.
Oh,
very high tackle there.
Very high tackle.
Down the court.
And
brilliant tackle there.
Have possession. And there's an advantage. The high tackle will be brought back on. I wonder if it's being looked into.
That was a high tackle.
That was
going down. Potentially no cards, but it was still a high tackle.
That was round his neck. Because we got a good view of that.
We'll see if there's any cards here. The ref is talking to York. And we'll see what's happening here. But they're looking to go for the post here. I heard Billy Charles.
I think they're going to try and extend their lead here, York.
Yeah.
Because obviously, if they get the penalty kick here, then it's no longer a one try game.
Again, I think there was no cards there due to mitigating factors to make you just go down this tackle.
Definitely.
Lancaster player was bracing for the tackle. Looks like.
Wait, so it's a very physical game.
Charles are chasing to go for the corner rather than the post. And it's a line out to York in a very dangerous position. We should try and see if we can.
We'll inch ever closer to the.
Trying not to get on the pitch.
No, because we're not playing.
Unfortunately not. Looks like a York line out in a very dangerous position for Lancaster. You're looking for another ball as it's been kicked over into the archery range. Probably a safe option not to go into the archery range.
No, definitely not.
To search the ball.
Maybe someone tried to shoot it out of the sky and just.
That would be impressive, like a Robin Hood scenario. Yeah, the ball has been gathered again and it's a York line out. Just a reminder, the score is 22-18.
So you used to play for the men's first team, did you not? No? And second?
No.
No?
And Lancaster have won the ball. Turnover as the ball was not thrown straight.
And these lineouts for York are really not materialising for them.
Great today.
Nope.
Again, maybe the referee just being more vigilant in lineouts.
Definitely.
It's good that these players learn from a young age about these lineouts as well. It's all about player development here, and it's exciting to see the referees do such a good job today. Really impressive reffing work.
Definitely. It's been some great reffing today, and the York players hyping themselves up for a last-minute push.
The ref is calling it's a dangerous scrum for Lancaster. Lancaster do not win this. It's next opportunity for York to take advantage of. And York.
Lancaster win that scrum easily.
Oh, it's a big tackle from
driven
York.
Driven back.
And it's a good clear out from Lancaster, though, equally.
Definitely. Some strong rucking once again.
Just kick that out.
Finding a great bit of space.
Lancaster have not got numbers out here, though, as they look to go back inside. York are really, really pushing high here. Again, in Lancaster's try line, they have to be really dangerous here.
He did have a good bit of space down that left-hand side, but he tried to cut in
York
straight
got
into
the ball.
It.
They've turned it over in a very dangerous position, and York could score here. They presented the ball. They're asking out for left wing, and it's a lofty pass. No one's out there on the left. No! He's knocked on. He was wide open. An unfortunate part of the game, but that was great for Lancaster. And that's the game. York have won it. It is a whitewash as University of Lancaster have yet to win a male rugby game. This Roses.
York have won by 4 points, with the score being 22 points to York and 18 to Lancaster. What a fantastic game.
A great game of rugby. The Lancaster fans are not looking too happy. They've travelled a long way and have lost every game of rugby. This Roses is a sad affair. But hey, they've travelled far, they've come down and they've played some really good rugby.
Absolutely. For an away team, that was a really, really impressive display. And some white smoke being...
And we can hear whitewash being chanted. Just a reminder, Roses are white in York. Roses
they
are red in Lancaster.
And Roses are...
I say, what a great game of rugby.
Absolutely. Well, Roses are white here on this pitch also, as York have proved today.
I mean... The score for Roses overall might not be red.
Yeah.
Might not be white even, sorry.
Definitely red.
The team would be really happy with themselves. They've performed very well over this Roses tournament, winning every single game they've had. This is what we love to see, great sportsmanship afterwards. Both teams shaking hands afterwards.
It's a gentleman's sport. It's a gentleman's sport.
And the white flares are being lit and smoke is coming through.
Absolutely.
Just a reminder, next game will be Lancaster 1's women's team versus University of York women's team. And that'll be
that's
the same pitch here.
Setting up for a great game.
Yeah, just a reminder, University of York women's team also won their game against Lancaster 2's. So if Lancaster 1's women's team can win against York, that'll stop the whitewash over rugby.
I'm sure Lancaster fans are disappointed, but they put out a great performance today. They really brought it back after a strong lead early on from York, but they clawed it back, and it was very close. And there were some moments definitely towards the end where, you know, Lancaster were very, very close, but just couldn't find the space.
Yeah. Unfortunate errors, unfortunate handling errors as well.
Definitely.
Mistakes in the line-out and scrums. It just didn't go into Lancaster's favour, but then, again, it was a great game of rugby, both sides, and...
Absolutely.
Be proud of what they've done today. I hope they enjoy themselves at home game.
Overall, a fantastic game of rugby.
Again. Gabe Newland, the captain of the University One's team, has been looking
I'm sure he will be. I'm sure he will be celebrating with lots and lots of orange juice.
And the coach of the University of York team has been lifted in the air, celebrating their whitewash over the rugby. It's great scenes for the University of York, and it'll be good. And commiserations to the University of York team. Again, looking happy and proud, though.
Definitely. There were some touchy moments. There was some, tensions flared, obviously. There's a lot of pressure.
Have you got a man of the match for today?
Have I got a man of the match for today?
I'd
like
to hear your thoughts.
Number 22 for Lancaster. Made some really, really good plays there and did some really good driving. Billy Charles was a great scrum half.
I would say Charlie Macy performed very well today, and his
very much
was very good, and his kicks were very good. We'll have an interview with Billy Charles in not too long.
Yeah.
To talk to him about what his thoughts were on the game. And we can see here both teams having a big huddle to talk about how they felt this game.
It's always nice to see. Always nice to see. But yeah, the York and the Lancaster fans have turned out in droves to watch this very, very close match, which York have just crawled ahead in.
Yeah, and great game of rugby. I just want to apologise for the mistakes for scoring. Again, that was our error.
We are not maths students.
Nor do we have a big school that tells us normally.
Or a referee talkback mic. So we're doing our best.
You know, so your rugby club are enjoying themselves, cheering loudly. We're talking with York sport people. So Frankie Riley, Sports Union president, is coming over. He's recording down the score. Potentially, we don't know if University of Lancaster have won roses yet, because last time we saw it was 154.
I will check.
But yeah, it's this could be a miracle comeback for University of York, but we shall see.
Or is it the beginning of the end?
Beginning of the end, we'll see, Jake. If you've got the score.
Lancaster have not yet won. They are inching ever closer with York on 85.5 points. I'm sure that's gone up now, because it was before, and obviously this is worth 4 points. So it will now be 89.5 points, I believe. And Lancaster on
a... Looks like Gabe Newland and Hicks come along, president and captain for an interview.
And Lancaster are on 155.5 points. So very, very close to that 164 threshold, which will lead them to victory.
Looks like some dads want their pictures of their sons. I mean, it's a great opportunity for families to come down to watch their kids play.
Definitely.
It must be great to perform so well in front of your parents or something like that.
Must be a very proud mum.
Yeah, exactly.
Because even, win or lose, it's a high-pressure environment, and everyone here has performed really, really well.
Yeah.
There's been some great rugby here.
I'm sure the after celebration will be huge. I'm sure a lot of these people stay here to watch the women's play, though, and cheer on their fellow counterparts.
Definitely.
And I would say it's been a really good game of rugby, and I think we're off to some interviews.
Everyone's running away.
And it's been a great game. Again, enjoyed the amount of fans here. And,
yeah. Atmosphere's been fantastic.
Can you hear me now?
Joined with Hicks come along, Gabriel, captain and president of the University of York rugby team. I want to say congratulations, guys, for winning roses overall as well. This is 1-2-3. How did the game go for you guys?
Yeah, thank you very much. Pretty tough, pretty physical old game, but felt like we had them in most areas of the game, actually. So
what's your plans now after this game?
Yeah, just a few settlers. Nothing major really. Power nap and then a big old court session later.
Was there any times during the game that you felt like you were losing, or scrappy, or was it all comfortable with the game as it was?
I think towards the end, obviously there was a lot of penalties conceded. Discipline was
bit erratic, but you know, we didn't let our heads drop. We didn't let it get to us. We just talked to the boys, you know, a few yellow cards, but we didn't let it get to us. We just sent it back up there and talked.
And as more of a club vote, you obviously can't see yourself. No, everyone put an absolute shift there. I don't think there was anyone that no one let it down. No one played better than anyone else. I thought it was just a real team effort. Kind of summed up your rock, really.
Thank you very much, and a lot of congratulations, guys, and good celebrations.
It's come along. There, celebrating the University of York Roses win, and that was a great turnout today. And thank you very much. That was Roses 2023 men's first.
They're not DJing today, as you can probably tell.
Yeah. How was it on the school?
22-18. I'm happy. Obviously, I couldn't say that.
What did you think?
Yeah. Not when I'm DJing.
Yeah. You like that,
bitch?
Are you a fan?
I'll be on my way back in a second.
My leg literally is like...